So hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing well. So in this video I'm going to talk about how you can make the chocolate using the blender. Okay, so without any further delay, now let's get started the tutorials. So here you can see guys, I have created one chocolate piece of chocolate and I have created some wavy effect. Okay, so what I use for both I'm just going to talk about first, then I will show you how I did. Okay guys, so here you can see this is my scene. Yeah, here you can see. So for making the chocolate I use the array modifier, here you can see, and I use the bevel as well. And for that effect, that Cadbury effect, I use the bullion. Okay, I will also show you how I did this. And here you can see, if I will turn off the array, so here you can see I have just created one piece of chocolate, and after that I use the array, here you can see. Okay guys, and for that I use the bullion, but I didn't apply the bullion because after that we can also edit further things. If you apply at once, can't use it again. Okay, because what is the use of the bullion like that? This is our bullion. Okay, so if I will move like that, so here you can, if I will move like that, here you can see it's editable. Okay, we can move, but if you will apply the bullion, after that you can't change the position, rotation and location. Okay, I will tell you also how I did like that. Okay, so yeah, and for that chocolate ocean I use the ocean modifier. Okay, and here you can see I use the ocean modifier for that, and I will also show you how I did. So now I'm just going to delete everything and let's start the tutorial from the scratch. And first of all guys, I just want to tell you one thing, you can download this project file free. I will put the link into the description, you can download from there free. And second thing, I use the SVG of the Cadbury logo. Okay, I here you can see, here I have a one Cadbury logo in my Illustrator. Okay, I export the SVG. Okay, and after that I import the SVG in Blender. Here you can see, here we have options, and if you not find that SVG option, so you can go to your edit preference, and here you have to just search the SVG, so you will find that. Okay, you can enable that add-on. And if you want to know how I did this, so you can see my that video. In that video I talk about how to convert 2D image into 3D, so you can see my that video. You will get better knowledge about the how to convert 2D image to into 3D. Okay, so same thing I apply here also, so you can see my that video if you don't know how to export the SVG into Blender. Okay, now let's start the tutorial. So I'm just going to delete everything, and I'm not going to delete that SVG because I need that. Okay, so I'm just going to hide it for a while, and I think I should keep that background as well. I'm just going to delete the both things. Okay, for example right now I'm hiding the background and that SVG as well. Okay, so now first of all what I will do, I will make one cube here. Okay, like that, and after that I'm going to scale it like that and little bit like that as well. Okay, yeah, and after that I'm just going to edit mode, and I will select the top face of that cube, and I will press the I for insert like that. Okay guys, and after that I will press the E for extrude. I think that is enough, and I'm going to scale it like that. So here you can see we have our piece of chocolate. Okay guys, so here you can see we have a piece of chocolate. I think it should little bit up, yeah, and yeah, here you can see, and I'm just going to add some bevel on it so it will look more organic. So for that what I will do, I'm just adding the bevel like that, yeah. So here you can see our bevel modifier is apply. Okay, so I think it's looking now more good, and we can change from here as well. Okay, I think it should be, I think it should be 6. Yeah, that is fine. Okay guys, now our piece of chocolate is ready. So what I'm just going to do, I'm just enable my Cadbury. So I'm just going to put that piece of chocolate behind it, that Cadbury logo, so we can easily, yeah. So I think that is fine. Yeah, here you can see. Okay guys, so if you want to see, so I'm just going to show you for a while. So here you can see, so we have that kind of Cadbury logo. Okay guys, so right now I'm just going to use the bullion modifier, so we can see the logo on top of the our chocolate piece of chocolate. Okay, so for that what I will do, I'm just going to select my chocolate, I'm going to the modifier stack, and here I will add the one bullion, and after that I will select that Cadbury logo and operation as a different. Okay, then after that what I will do, I'm just going to select my Cadbury logo and go to the object properties, and here I will change display as a wire. Okay, and I'm just going to hide like that. So here you can see, right now we can see the some edges here. Okay, that is not looking cool. So how you can rid of these edges? So for that you have to just unhide your Cadbury and select that and press the right click and do shade smooth, and after that you can hide it. So here you can see these edges become now smooth. Okay, so here you can see guys, we have our Cadbury logo on top of our chocolate. Okay guys, so now I'm just going to add the array modifier, so we can make our chocolate complete. Okay, so for that again I will select my chocolate, and I will go to the modifier stack, and here I will add one array modifier. So here you can see, so I'm just going to increase the count, number of 3 count like that, and after that I need vertical as well. So for that I will do copy again, and I'm just going to change the offset X to Y like that, and I'm just going to increase the amount 5. Okay guys, so here you can see now we have our chocolate. Okay, and for a while I'm just going to hide the camera because it's disturbing us. Yeah, so here you can see we have our chocolate and it's looking cool. And the main important thing why I use the bevel like that, so now I'm going to show you. So here you can see, now I'm going to unhide that, and if I will do any kind of change in that bevel, so here you can see it will affect the each and every. So if you need a more bevel, so you can drag it down. If you need a little bevel like that, you can do like that, so you can manage from here. Okay, how much depth you need it. So I think that much is enough. Okay, it's looking cool. Here you can see. Okay guys, so our chocolate is ready. Okay, so now I'm just going to add the material on it, chocolate material. So I have already tried lots of material. Okay, but I just finalized that one. Okay, it's looking good on it. So I'm just going to show you. Yes. So here you can see, now we have a material in on our chocolate. Okay, so now I'm just going to make the ocean. Okay, that chocolate ocean. So for that what I will do, I'm just going to add one plane here. Okay, I'm just pulling that down like that, and I'm just putting down to the chocolate, and after that I will go to the modifier stack, and here I will add the ocean modifier. So here you can see we have ocean modifier. I'm just going to scale a little bit like that. Okay guys, so now I'm just going to my camera view. So this is my camera view. So now we need to change the settings. Okay, so first of all I should change the resolution. So when I change the resolution, here you can see we get more smooth ocean layers. Okay, then after that I'm just going to change my choppiness. So I think we should use the 0.01 is fine, I think. Yeah, and I'm just going to scale it. So I think 1.6 is fine. Okay, and you can change the that shallow as well, and you can change the scale a little bit. You can repeat this as well if you want to repeat. Okay, so I'm just going to change the depth, and this is the time. Basically it's used for animate your ocean, and you can try the random seed as well because sometimes it's working good. Okay guys, so I'm just using the choppiness like that. I'm just going to so I think that is fine. And I'm decreasing the choppiness. So here you can see it's looking cool. Okay, and if you want to exactly same whatever I show you before, so you need to give the more time for to make that kind of effect. Okay guys, so right now I'm just going to show you, I'm just giving an example how you can make this. So here you can see you can change the wave size as well. Okay, you can change the choppiness little bit, and yeah, I think that is fine. So now I'm just going to add the same material on the ocean as well. So for that, what I will do, I will select my ocean, and after that I will select my chocolate. I will do Control L, and I will make link as a material. So here you can see we have a material in our chocolate as well, chocolate ocean as well. Okay, and if you find the gap, so you can just do like that. Okay, make some more organic feel. Here you can see now it's looking cool. Okay, yeah, and I use the HDRI. Here you can see I use the HDRI here, and I'm just using the HDRI add-on. Okay, it's called Gaffer. So if you want to know how to use this add-on, so I have already make one video on it. You can see my that video. I have described each and everything in that video. Okay, and it's very helpful to adding the light in your scene very quickly. Okay guys, so you can you can see my that video. You will better get to know about it. So right now I'm just using the gaffer. Okay, I'm just going to unhide my plane which is I have make. Okay, that background basically. So yeah, that is fine. So now if I will take the render, so here you can see guys we have a beautiful chocolate here, and it's look like it's dumping the chocolate ocean. Okay, so here you can see, so that's how you can make the your chocolate in using the blender. So I think you will get to know how to make the chocolate in blender, and maybe in the next video I will make some animation video on it. Okay, so most probably I will make it. Okay, so stay tuned with me guys, and thanks for watching this video guys. If you learn something in this video, please hit the like button, hit the share button, and subscribe my channel also. And if you have any queries, if you have any suggestion, please let me know in the comment box. I will definitely reply your comment. So bye bye, take care, stay home.